will fuel your city's future? One answer might be an unexpected source. The non-recycled materials we throw out every day. While mechanical recycling is at an all-time high, there's an enormous amount of energy and value locked in the non-recycled materials we send to landfills. But new technologies are converting those materials into fuels to power our future, and even into new chemicals for manufacturing.
But whatever is generated in society should be put to a use. It should create energy. We really can avoid landfilling that material and leaving it for the next generation or the next generations.
In Edmonton, Canada, city officials with active community input connected with a private company called Enerkem on a project to turn municipal solid waste and non-recycled materials into clean alternative fuels and chemicals. Edmonton established community communication and trust, and over time had already created a high rate of recycling and became the home of the largest co-composting facility in North America. But they knew that embracing new technology could move them much closer to a goal of 90% diversion from landfill. Together, Edmonton researched their options: waste to energy, fuels, or chemicals. They found support for the world's first industrial-scale municipal solid waste to fuels and chemicals facility.
The Enerkem technology can be used by communities around the world to convert their waste to a valuable resource. It can be used to make fuels and chemicals that reduce greenhouse gas emissions and displace fossil fuels.
Enerkem's thermochemical process uses a sealed chemical reaction to transform non-recycled materials from a solid state into a gas. The gas is then converted into automotive fuels or other valuable chemical products for manufacturing. Engineers have found that non-recycled plastics can actually improve the process performance.
Because plastics have high energy content, we anticipate that that will improve the energy efficiency. Because of the molecular makeup of plastics, we should get a better quality carbon and hydrogen molecular structure coming out. And then, of course, overall, it should reduce the emissions that are seen in the process.
Despite increases in plastics recycling, some plastics are not easily recycled. Chemical recycling technologies provide a great option to produce valuable energy and chemical products from previously landfilled material.
I think it's important that everybody learns that plastics do have an end-of-life use that will be turning waste into energy, which is something we all need and use.
The template is there to bring community, industry, environmentalists, officials, political leaders, and other key stakeholders together for a more sustainable, integrated approach that combines mechanical recycling, composting, and chemical recycling together at one facility. New technologies can give any municipality the potential to convert waste materials formerly sent to landfills into cleaner energy or everyday products.
Understanding it now and putting in your efforts to really make this work is absolutely the future.
We can stop thinking about trash like it's the 1990s. The 21st century will be about managing our post-use materials more effectively and sustainably. To learn more about how waste, including non-recycled plastic, can fuel the cities of tomorrow and achieve valuable environmental benefits, visit chemical-recycling.com.